Teaching children how to code is a wonderful thing. Giving them a basic exposure of what it's like to write their own programs can spark an interest that may one day lead them into a career in technology. The challenge, of course, is that learning to code isn't an easy thing even for adults. So how can we effectively teach kids to write their own software? I'm going to introduce you to a children's programming language that I created called Tuvi. Tuvi is an extremely simple language that allows children, or adults, to write text-based games that can be run from the command prompt. What's nice about Tuvi is that you can explain it to a kid in less than 10 minutes, and they'll be programming with it right away, even if they've never even heard of a programming language before. And I've seen this with my own eyes. The classic use case for Tuvi is creating text-based adventure games, similar to the Choose Your Own Adventure books out there. Tuvi is written in Ruby, and is actually what's known as a Ruby internal domain-specific language, which basically means that Tuvi is really just Ruby under the hood. As such, we run Tuvi programs the same way we run Ruby programs. Let me demonstrate to you a real game built with Tuvi. Okay, so it says, "Welcome, type exit to quit at any time. You have just woken up from a fitful sleep. You get out of your bed, and you realize that you are not in your bedroom. As your eyes take in your surroundings, you realize that you are in some sort of dungeon. How did I get here, you wonder? You see a small table with a key on it." And here Tuvi prompts us to choose a command. Now here there's only one command of take key, so let's enter that. You're holding the key. In front of you is a locked door with three locks. One is painted red, one is painted blue, and one is painted black. Which lock do you want to try the key on? So now we have a choice of three commands, red, blue, and black. Let's start with red, and that didn't work. Perhaps the key would work on a different lock. Let's try blue, and that didn't work either. So let's go for black. It worked. The door swings open slowly, and you enter what seems to be a dark hallway. Eventually, the hallway comes to a pair of staircases, one of which goes up, and the other of which goes down. You hear footsteps on the floor above you, and you wonder which staircase you should take. Okay, we're not going to play the whole game right now because I'm sure you've got the point. But what I want to show you is that the syntax for building a game like this is really, really simple in Tuvi, that even a child can do it. Let's exit. Now, if you already have Ruby installed on your computer, you can install Tuvi with a simple gem install Tuvi. And then in your text editor, you can open up a new file. Here I've named the file castle.rb, and note that it's a Ruby file, so it ends with the .rb extension, because again, Tuvi is really just Ruby under the hood. The first thing we need to do to get started is require the Tuvi gem. We then build the game by setting up the various steps of the program. Each step of the game follows a similar pattern. The computer prints some text to the screen, and then presents the user with several commands to choose from. The user types in the command of his or her choice, and then the program proceeds to the next step. This will become clearer as we write our first program. Let's start with the first step. Step, start, do. Here we're setting up the first step of the game, which is known as start. Next, we have the computer print some text to the screen with the say command. So I'm going to steal the text from the game we just looked at and paste that in. So at the beginning of the game, this text is printed to the terminal. Next, we offer the user one or more responses that he or she can choose from. We do that with the response keyword. For each response we offer the user, we have a new response line. In the first step, we only offer one response. So we say response, followed by the string, which is the command that we allow the user to type in. That's followed by a hash rocket arrow. And that leads to the name of the next step that this response leads to. And we'll call that step door. We'll then end this step. Then we'll start another step called door. And for now, we'll leave it empty. So to review, the game starts with the start step, and it's actually necessary to call the step that you're going to start with start. The computer then prints this all to the terminal, and then offers the user one response. In this case, the take key response. And you read this line as saying, if the user responds with take key, then go to this step, namely the door step. The door step is now defined over here, but we just have to fill it in still. So let's do that. And again, I'm going to copy and paste. This is where it says you're holding the key, and you have a red blue and black lock to choose from. Now in this case, we offer the user three possible responses. We offer the red response, which will lead to a step that we'll call locked door. We'll offer a blue response, which will also lead to the locked door step. And then finally, we'll give a black option, which will lead to the open door step. We can then make those two steps. Let's start with the locked door. And we'll start with the message of that didn't work. And then we'll actually offer these same three responses and end that step. Then we'll have the open door step. And then we'll say a message and offer the responses of up and down. And at this point, the Tuvi syntax is probably quite clear to you. And this is the core functionality of Tuvi. There are a growing number of more advanced features as Tuvi is an open source project under development. But this is the core of the language and, as you can probably imagine, it's simple enough for a child. Now that you understand how to build games with Tuvi, the next step is setting up a development environment for the child you're teaching. And that can be tricky. One obvious option is going through the process of installing Ruby onto the computer the child has access to, and then downloading Tuvi as the Ruby gem with the command gem install Tuvi, as we demonstrated earlier. If you followed this route, you'd also have to get the child set up with a simple text editor, and you'll also have to show the child how to access the command prompt and a little bit of how to navigate to the various folders with it. And although this is certainly feasible, I'd like to recommend a much easier and faster way to get the child up and running with creating his or her own programs. And that is by using a cloud-based development environment service. The one that I like to use is Nitrous. Nitrous can be found at the website nitrous.io, and it's an excellent online service that provides you with development environments on the cloud. And this includes both the text editor as well as the command prompt. Although Nitrous has paid options, you can get simple development environments for free. For using Tuvi, a simple development environment is all you need. I'll show you how quickly you can get a Nitrous box up and running. At nitrous.io, you can sign up for a free account. Click on the Sign Up for Free button. It will ask you to confirm your registration by way of confirmation email. After you've confirmed by clicking on the email link, you'll be prompted to create your first box. Be sure to choose the Ruby Rails option, since of course we'll need Ruby to be installed in order to run Tuvi. You can choose any name for this box that you want. I'll call it Tuvi, and I'll click on Create Box. It gives you some options here, but let's just click on OK, take me to my box, then click on the box that we just created, which I named Tuvi. It might take a minute or so to load up, but then you'll have some options here. Let's just click on IDE, and then we're brought to our box on Nitrous. The bottom part of the screen here is the terminal, and the top part of the screen in the center is the text editor. So from our terminal, let's just start with gem install Tuvi. And then in the text editor, let's open up a new file, and I'm just going to paste in our Haunted Castle code. Here's the program we've been working with. Now I'll save the file. I will call it hauntedcastle.rb, and I'll click Save. You can see that the text editor takes on some color once it recognizes that it's a Ruby file. And now in the terminal, we can simply run the Tuvi game by doing Ruby Haunted Castle, and it starts the game. As you can see, this is a great way to quickly get a child up and running with a development environment in which he or she can start writing programs right away. Tuvi is open source, and we're always looking for improvements and new features. You can find out more at the official Tuvi project page or in the Tuvi repo on GitHub. You can make a difference in a child's life by giving him or her a taste of what computer programming is all about. Tuvi makes it really easy to get a child started on programming, and perhaps one day the child will eventually pursue a career in software technology.